Now we shall learn the use of range in link. This is how, first of all we learn how range is used, what is the use of range, and then we learn where can it be used. Range is used to generate a sequence or list of integers. It is a sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or if say between 110, 111, 112, 113, like that. So we can write like this, where x is equal to enumerable dot range 10, 25. X will ultimately contain a list of integers from 10 to 25. So the purpose of range is to generate a sequence of integers between two limits. It is more efficient. Rather than using the longer way like list, angle bracket, int, and then in a for loop, you add one them one by one. So instead of that, this is a one step method for generating a sequence of integers. Its use I'll come in a moment. You can also do one thing. Suppose you want to generate, instead of a flat sequence like 10, 11, you can also generate, let us say, squares of the numbers. For example, we can write where x is equal to enumerable dot range, range 10, 25, then dot select x goes to x star x. So what will this generate? This will generate a sequence of numbers, squares of numbers between 10 and 25. So it will contain 100, 121 and like that. You can pass a lambda like this, calculator like this. So this is the use of range, this is the way range is used. You can use that select function to generate a square of list of squares of integers between 10 and 25. Now why would we use it? That's the more interesting thing here. We have seen for loops. We write for int I is equal to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus. This is a traditional for loop. There is a small problem with this. If somebody accidentally writes a line here, I is equal to 5, some more lines here, then this for loop will never exit and this will be a bug here. This accidental writing, because I is changeable inside for loop. There is one very important distinction between for and for each which you should understand. Variables, local variables inside a for loop are changeable. I is a local variable inside this for loop. You can change it inside it, no issues. I is equal to 5, I is equal to I plus 1, these changes are allowed. And we have always done them. Since the days of C language, we have been doing them, and it has been like that, and it is like that in C sharp also. But when it comes to for each loop, local variables inside a for each are not changeable. I can't write for each, let us say, string s in some list, or let me erase it and write it this way, like for each c student data CS in LS. Here CS is a local variable for this for each loop. It represents each C student data inside LS. Now I can't write CS dot name equal to A. That is, CS is not changeable here. If you compile it with .NET 4.5, that is Visual Studio 2012, then this will throw an exception. You can check it with Visual Studio 2012. In earlier versions, exception was not thrown, but a warning was there. But it was never allowed. You could never alter this, even in earlier versions. Since day one, it has been mentioned for foreach that local variables inside foreach are not alterable. So let me now see, first of all, how to write a foreach loop, a for loop using foreach syntax. I can write foreach int I in enumerable dot range 0, 10. Now you will understand. I am writing int I in enumerable dot range. Enumerable dot range is returning a sequence, a collection, and a collection is being iterated in a for each loop. The same for int for loop has been written as for each loop by if, because this range is available to us. Now inside this, if I write a line accidentally, then this will throw an exception, because I is a local variable inside a for each loop which can't be altered. So this is one way in which you will find that the range is very useful. You can altogether avoid writing for loop inside C#. But it doesn't mean that for loop doesn't have its own uses. If you want to alter some element of this collection during iteration, then you can use for loop. But if you want to prevent that alteration, then always use foreach loop, because foreach will always prevent this alteration, and this will make your code more robust. And enumerable dot range gives you the equivalent of a for loop. So I hope this is clear. Let us now see how we can use link range in an example. So this has already been explained. I enumerable int scares is equal to enumerable dot range 1 to 10 dot select scares. So this collection contains a list of scares, and we have used a string builder. For each int I in scares, so you see I am writing a for loop with for each syntax, and this time this scares is a collection of scares. Although this is not strictly that I am replacing a for loop, but that looks like the way I was explaining in the earlier one. The purpose is entirely different here. Actually, we are iterating over all the scares inside that collection. So if you see the output, output will be I is equal to 0, I is equal to 1, I is equal to 4, I is equal to 9. So like that you will get this output. So this is how we use enumerable dot range in link.